My dear students, Namaste, good morning to you all, and also welcome to another session of our mathematics class. In the previous session, we have completed chapter number 4, determinants. Hope you have revised well and cleared all your doubts. In today's session, we shall discuss the new chapter, that is vector algebra. Let's move on to the topic. Many times we come across quantities where value expressed in numbers is good enough. For example, height of Qutub Minar is 73 meter. Mass of a basketball is 624 gram. But sometimes we need to answer questions like how much should I walk from point A to point B? If I say 30 meter, that is not the enough information because I can walk 30 meter in any direction from point A. So it is very important to know the distance as well as direction of movement. The quantities which require only on value or magnitude are called scalar quantities. For example, height, mass, temperature, etc. The quantities which require magnitude as well as direction are called vector quantities. Example, velocity, force, acceleration, displacement, etc. Next, we shall discuss more about vectors. A quantity that has magnitude as well as direction is called a vector, denoted as vector AB. Means you have to write AB, and on top of AB there is an arrow. It shows the direction starting from A ending at B, or simply as vector A, small letter A you can use as before. On top of A there is an arrow, and read as vector AB or vector A. Consider a line L. On line L there is a directed line segment AB. Directed line segment in the sense it shows the direction starting from A and going to B. This is called vector AB, and the starting point of the vector, that is A, is called the initial point, and the end point, that is B, is called the terminal point. And the length of AB, or simply the distance between A and B, is called the magnitude of the vector AB. Here the point A from where the vector AB starts is called its initial point, and the point B where it ends is called its terminal point. It's shown here in the diagram. The distance between the initial and terminal points of a vector is called the magnitude or the length of the vector, denoted as modulus of AB or modulus of A, vector AB or vector A. Next, we shall discuss position vector. Consider a three-dimensional coordinate system having x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and there is a origin there, that is a meeting point of x, y and z-axis, that is O, 0, 0, 0. Consider a point P, x, y, z in the space, and vector OP is called the position vector represented by R. The vector OP having O and P are initial and terminal points respectively is called the position vector of the point P with respect to O. Here O is the origin and P is the position of the point on the space. So vector OP is called the position vector. The magnitude of OP or R is given by the formula root of x square plus y square plus z square. X, y, z are the coordinates. So root of x square plus y square plus z square is the magnitude of the position vector OP. Please note, in practice, the position vectors of points A, B, C, etc. with respect to the origin O are denoted by vector A, vector B, vector C, etc. respectively. Let's visualize it. Consider the three-dimensional coordinate system having axis x, y and z, and let's mark the origin and the position vectors of A, B and C, means from O to A, O to B and O to C. So OA, OB and OC etc. are called the position vectors of A, B and C. These are represented by the letters A, B, C, vector A, vector B, vector C, etc. Next, we shall discuss the types of vectors. First one is zero vector or null vector. A vector whose initial and terminal points coincide is called a zero vector or null vector and is denoted as vector O. Here, a vector whose initial and terminal points coincide means initial and terminal points are same. If you visualize, there will be only a single dot there. The vector which is start from where it starts there itself, it is ending. So there is a single dot and we can represent it by using letter A. Here, please note that the magnitude of a zero vector is zero, because magnitude means the length of the vector. Here, the vector from where it starts there itself, it is ending. So no magnitude, no length can be measured. A zero vector has no fixed direction as well. Since there is no length, no way to go, so there is no direction as well. Next one is the unit vector. A vector whose magnitude is 1 is called a unit vector. It is also called a direction vector. The unit vector in the direction of the vector A is denoted by A cap. This is vector A and is denoted by A cap. On top of A, there is a cap, just like an arrow we have to keep. So unit vector means the magnitude. The magnitude of the vector is 1. So the distance from A to B is 1. So this is called the unit vector, and this unit vector is also called the direction vector. This is also called the direction vector. Please note this one. Okay. The next one is co-initial vectors. Two or more vectors having the same initial point are called co-initial vector. From the name itself, we can define this one co-initial. Co-initial in the sense, two or more vectors having the same initial point. So here, initial point A is same for both vector AB and vector AC. So here A is common for both AB and vector AC. So AB and vector AB and vector AC are co-initial vectors because they are having the same starting point or the initial point. Next, we shall discuss collinear vectors. Two or more vectors are said to be collinear if they are parallel to the same line irrespective of their magnitudes and directions. Means two or more vectors are said to be collinear in the sense they must be parallel to a given line, no matter the length of the vector or the direction of the vector. Whatever be the magnitude and direction, it is not a problem. The given vectors must be parallel to a given line. Let's visualize it. There is a line L. There are vectors which is parallel to the given line L. That means vector QP, vector CD, vector FE and vector AB. These vectors are parallel to the line L. That is, L is parallel to vector AB, which is parallel to vector CD, which is parallel to vector FE, and which is parallel to vector QP. So here, please note, as we have discussed before, collinear vectors may have different magnitude. No problem how much the length is. Collinear vectors may have opposite direction. Not a matter in which direction the vector is moving. So only one condition is collinear vector in the sense they must be parallel to a given line, parallel to the same line. Next, we shall discuss equal vectors. Two vectors, vector A and vector B, are said to be equal if they have the same magnitude and direction. Means if two vectors are equal in the sense their magnitude, means their length and their direction must be same. Here, AB and CD, two vectors are shown in the figure, and length of AB and length of CD is same, means magnitude is same and they are moving towards the same direction. When you check the arrow, it is clear they are moving towards the same direction, means they are having same direction and the same magnitude. So we can write it as vector AB is equal to vector CD. Please note that the equal vectors may have different initial and terminal points. Next is negative vectors. Two vectors with the same magnitude but opposite directions are called negative vectors of each other. Here, AB and CD is having the same magnitude, means the length of AB and length of CD is same. Here, the direction of AB means starting from A, ending at B, means initial point is A and the terminal point is B. And in vector DC, the initial point is D and the terminal point is C. So these two vectors are negative vectors because they are having the same magnitude but opposite direction. One is moving from A to B, another one is moving just opposite of that. They are having opposite direction, because of that they are called the negative vectors. The important result is vector BA is equal to minus of vector AB, means here you can change the direction of the given vector. Here in the first case, left hand side BA starting is at B and ending is at A, means initial point is B and the terminal point is A. You can write it as vector AB. Here in vector AB, on the right hand side, initial point is A and terminal point is B. Here you change the direction, but you have to put a negative sign. Once again, vector BA, we can write it as vector AB, but you have to put a negative sign. So vector BA is equal to minus of vector AB. Please note, all equal vectors are collinear vectors. Equal vectors in the sense, we have already learned here, they are having the same magnitude and direction. Collinear vector in the sense, they are parallel to a given line. Here, all collinear vectors are not equal vectors. Collinear vector in the sense, they must be parallel to a single line, but irrespective of their magnitude and direction, they are collinear vectors. But equal vector in the sense, they must have the same magnitude and direction. So collinear vectors are not equal vectors. All collinear vectors are not equal vectors. Next, we shall discuss addition of vectors. Here we have to learn two laws. The first one is triangle law of vector addition, and the second one is parallelogram law of vector addition. In the first case, that is triangle law of vector addition, consider a situation. Suppose a girl moves from point A to point B and then from point B to point C. Her net displacement AC can be calculated by adding AB and BC. In other words, vector AB plus vector BC is equal to vector AC. That is triangle law of vector addition. Once again, vector AB plus vector BC is equal to vector AC. Here when you check, vector AB and vector BC are having some properties, that is AB ends at B and BC starts at B, means the terminal point of first vector and the initial point of the second vector must be same. Then we can say that AB plus BC must be equal to AC. So here the directions you must note: A to B, then from B to C, then the third one is from A to C. In simple language, if you say consider a vector A and the terminal point of vector A is here, from here we are starting the another vector, that is B, then A plus B is the third side of the triangle, that is this one, A plus B. This is called the triangle law of vector addition. Next, we shall discuss parallelogram law of vector addition. Consider a vector A and another vector B. And if you observe A and B, they are co-initial vectors. They are starting from the same starting point. And if you complete this triangle, the third side of the triangle is not equal to vector A plus vector B, because vector A and B are co-initial vectors. So you have to form a parallelogram, means the same angle and direction and also the same magnitude. We have to draw B here, and A with the same magnitude of A, same angle and direction, we have to draw another A to complete the parallelogram. And when you observe now, this A, the terminal point is this one and the initial point of B is here, means the terminal point of A and the initial point of B is same here, means if you complete the diagonal of the parallelogram, the diagonal of the parallelogram will be equal to A plus B. So diagonal of the parallelogram, we can write it as A plus B. So this is called the parallelogram law of vector addition. Here A plus B comes because this A, the terminal point is here, and this vector B, the initial point is this one. So the third side of this triangle, or the diagonal of the parallelogram, we can write as A plus B, vector A plus vector B. So this is called the parallelogram law of vector addition. Next, we shall discuss components of a vector. Let us take the points A100, B010 and C001 on the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis respectively. Let's plot these points on the x, y and z-axis. A100 we have plotted on the x-axis, B010 plotted on y-axis and C001 on the z-axis. If you observe, the length of OA is 1 unit, length of OB is 1 unit and length of OC also 1 unit. Means vector OA, vector OB and vector OC magnitude is 1 unit. Therefore, we can say that vector OA, vector OB and vector OC are unit vectors represented by I cap, J cap and K cap. Here I cap is the unit vector along X axis or OX, J cap is the unit vector along Y axis or OY, K cap is the unit vector along Z axis or OZ. Let's write these things here. Modulus of OA, vector OA, modulus of vector OB and modulus of vector OC is 1 unit. Therefore, vector OA, vector OB and vector OC each have a magnitude 1. They are called unit vectors along the axis OX, OY and OZ. And they are denoted by I, J and K respectively. Consider a point P, X, Y, Z. We are going to write the component form of the position vector of P, that is OP. Position vector OP is OP. Here X, in the sense X is a distance. X axis distance is X, Y axis distance is Y and Z axis distance is Z. Here X, Y and Z are all scalar quantities. X is a distance, Y is also a distance and Z also a distance. X is a distance on X axis, Y is on Y axis and Z is a distance on Z axis. If I multiply X with I, we get a vector having X length on the X axis. If I multiply X with I, we get a vector having X length on the X axis because I is the unit vector along X axis. And if I multiply Y with J, I get a vector having Y length on the Y axis. Similarly, if I multiply Z with K, I will get a vector having Z length on the Z axis. So, the position vector of P with reference to O is given by OP, vector OP or R, vector R is equal to XI plus YJ plus ZK. So, XI cap plus YJ cap plus ZK cap. This form of any vector is called its component form. Here X, Y and Z are called the scalar components. I have mentioned before X, Y and Z are only the distances. So they are called the scalar components. XI plus YJ plus ZK, XI cap, YJ cap and ZK cap are called vector components of R along the respective axis. Here we have to note the magnitude of any vector R is equal to XI cap plus YJ cap plus ZK cap is given by modulus of R is equal to modulus of XI plus YJ plus ZK is equal to, this is a very important formula, root of X square plus Y square plus Z square. So the magnitude of any vector can be calculated by using the formula root of X square plus Y square plus Z square. And one more thing that is very important formula again, R cap means unit vector R. Any vector we can convert into unit vector, that is formula is vector R divided by modulus of vector R. Means you have to calculate the modulus by using the formula X square plus Y square plus Z square. So you have to take the given vector and you have to divide the given vector by its modulus, then that vector will be converted into unit vector. So r cap is equal to vector r divided by modulus of r. Hope it is clear. Next, we shall discuss addition and subtraction of vectors in component form. Consider two vectors, a is equal to 3i plus 2j plus 5k, vector b is equal to 5i plus 3j plus 2k. Here, let's discuss the addition of vector a plus vector b is equal to, just add the scalar components. Here scalar component is 3 and 5. So 3 plus 5 together into I cap plus 2 plus 3 into j cap plus 5 plus 2 into k cap. Then 3 plus 5 is 8 I cap plus 2 plus 3 is 5 j cap plus 5 plus 2 is 7 k cap. So this is a plus b. Next we shall discuss a minus b. Just subtract the components, scalar components, 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5 into I cap. Next is 2 minus 3. 2 minus 3 into j cap plus 5 minus 2 into k cap. That is equal to 3 minus 5 is minus 2i. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. That is minus j cap. Plus 5 minus 2 is 3, that is 3k cap. Next, we shall discuss vector joining two points. If p1, x1, y1, z1 and p2, x2, y2, z2 are any two points, then the vector joining p1 and p2 is the vector p1, p2. Let's visualize these two points on the plane. We have taken p1, x1, y1, z1 and p2, x2, y2, z2 on the coordinate plane. And we are going to discuss about the formula for calculating vector P1, P2. Vector P1, P2 in the sense initial point is P1 and the terminal point is P2. This is very important. In vector P1, P2, initial point is P1 and the terminal point is P2. So vector P1, P2 is equal to the terminal points, you have to take the coordinates of terminal point, you have to take first. That is P2 is the terminal point here. P2 coordinates are x2, y2, z2. So you have to start from x2. X2 minus x1 into I cap plus y2 minus y1 into j cap plus z2 minus z1 into k cap. Means here the second one coordinates you have to take. Terminal points coordinates you have to start. That is x2, y2, z2 are the coordinates. Then x2 minus x1 into I cap plus y2 minus y1 into j cap plus z2 minus z1 into k cap is the formula for finding p1, p2, vector p1, p2. Next, we shall discuss exercise 10.1. First question. Represent graphically a displacement of 40 km 30 degree east of north. Displacement of 40 km 30 degree east of north. First of all, let's draw the directions, that is north, south, east, west. We have drawn. Then 30 degree east of north. North is this one. East of north is this portion. Right side of north is east of north. Then 30 degree we have to mark from north. Use your protractor and mark 30 degree. And by using your ruler, draw a line. And here displacement of 40 km. 30 degree already we have marked. Then we have to go for marking this 40 km. Since the unit is in kilometer, we have to use a scale. That 1 centimeter is 10 km we are taking. So 40 km means 4 centimeter you have to cut on this line. So first 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter and then 4 centimeter. So that represents 4 units, or in original it is 40 km. So we have now represented graphically a displacement of 40 km, that is 30 degree east of north. Next we shall discuss question number 4. The question is, in figure identify the following vectors. There is a diagram given to you, there is a figure which is given to you. First one is co-initial vector we have to identify. Second one is equal vectors. Third one is collinear but not equal. So let's go for finding out the vectors. First one, co-initial vector. Co-initial vector we have already learned. Vectors which are having the same initial point or the same starting point. When you look at this figure or diagram, it is clear that vector A and vector D are starting from this particular point, means they are having the same initial point. So vectors A and D are co-initial. Next one, we have to identify equal vectors. Equal vectors, we have already learned that equal vectors mean they should have the same magnitude and direction. Here you can see vector D is going towards downwards, and here vector B also going down. So both vector B and D are having same direction and equal in magnitude as well. So vector B and D are equal. Third one, collinear but not equal. Collinear in the sense, we have already learned collinear vectors means they are parallel to a same line but not equal. Collinear but not equal. They must be parallel to a particular line but they must not be equal. So here A and C are parallel, but the direction of A and C, when you check, they are having opposite direction. So A and C are collinear, they are parallel, but the direction is opposite. Because of that, they are not equal. So the answer is vectors A and C are collinear but not equal. Next, we shall discuss question number 5. Question is, answer the following as true or false. The first statement is vector A and minus A are collinear. So we have already learned that collinear vectors means vectors which are parallel to the same line. Here A and minus A are parallel to the same line. So the statement is true. The next one is, two collinear vectors are always equal in magnitude. We have already learned collinear vectors means they are parallel to the same line, but they may be equal in magnitude or may not. So the given statement is, two collinear vectors are always equal in magnitude. So the given statement is false. Next one is, two vectors having the same magnitude are collinear. Again, just recall the collinear vectors definition. Collinear vector means vectors which are parallel to the same line. So two vectors are having same magnitude. If they have the same magnitude, doesn't mean that they are parallel to a same line. So the given statement is false. Next one is, two collinear vectors having the same magnitude are equal. Once again, collinear vector definition, that is vectors which are parallel to a same line, having the same magnitude are equal. If two vectors are equal means they should have the same magnitude as well as direction. Here nothing is telling about the direction. So the given statement is false. Exercise 10.2, first question. The question is, compute the magnitude of the following vectors. We have to find out the magnitude of the given vectors. That is, vector A is equal to I cap plus J cap plus K cap. Vector B is equal to 2 I cap minus 7 J cap minus 3 K cap. Vector C is equal to 1 by root 3 I cap plus 1 by root 3 J cap minus 1 by root 3 K cap. We have to find out the magnitude of the given vectors. We have already learned that the magnitude of a vector which is in the form xi plus yj plus zk is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square. So let's calculate the magnitude of vector A. Magnitude of vector A or modulus of vector A is equal to root of x square. Here x component is, or the scalar component is 1. 1 and 1. X value is 1, y value is 1, z value also 1. So 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square, that is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. Final answer root 3. Next one, modulus of B is equal to root of, here the scalar components are 2, minus 7 and minus 3. So 2 square plus minus 7 the whole square plus minus 3 the whole square, by using x square plus y square plus z square formula. That is equal to 2 square is 4, minus 7 square is 49, minus 3 square is 9. When you add these three quantities, we will get as root 62. Next one is modulus of vector C. Modulus of vector C is equal to, here the scalar components are 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3 and minus 1 by root 3. So let's calculate this one. X square plus y square plus z square. That is 1 by root 3 the whole square plus 1 by root 3 the whole square plus 1 by root 3 the whole square. That is equal to 1 by root 3 the whole square is 1 by 3. Here also 1 by root 3 the whole square. That is 1 by 3 plus 1 by root 3 the whole square is 1 by 3. When you take 3 as common LCM, numerator will be 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is root of 3 by 3. Root of 3 by 3 is root 1. The final answer we will get as 1. Next, we shall discuss question number 2. Question is, write two different vectors having the same magnitude. So we are asked to write two different vectors which are having the same magnitude. We have already learned the formula for finding the magnitude of a vector. That is x square plus y square plus z square. These x, y and z are the scalar components. So it's quite easy to write vectors having the same magnitude. First of all, we will write a vector. That is a is equal to I minus 2j plus 3k. You can write any vector, it's not a problem. Here I am taking I cap minus 2j cap plus 3k cap. So we should write another vector which is having the same magnitude of vector a. Here magnitude calculation is always depends upon the scalar components, that is x square plus y square plus z square. Here the scalar components are 1, minus 2 and 3. So by using these 1, 2 and 3 in different order, we have to write another vector, then both the vectors will be having the same magnitude. Here b, I am writing vector b is equal to the same scalar components only I am using, 1, 2 and 3. Here next vector I am writing as 2i plus j minus 3k. 2i cap plus j cap minus 3k cap. Here also when you check the scalar components, 2, 1 and minus 3 means 2, 1 and 3. The order is different, that's all. So let's calculate the magnitude of these two vectors. Magnitude of vector a is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square. That is 1 square plus minus 2 the whole square plus 3 square. X is 1, y is minus 2, z is 3. So after calculating, 1 square is 1, minus 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9. So root of 14 we will get as modulus of a. Next is magnitude of b we will calculate. That is equal to 2 square plus 1 square plus minus 3 square. X square plus y square plus z square formula if you apply we will get. That is equal to 2 square is 4, 1 square is 1, minus 3 square is 9. If we add 4, 1 and 9 we will get as root 14. Now the magnitude of first vector and the second vector is same. So modulus of A is equal to modulus of B, but A and B are not equal vectors. We wrote two different vectors, but their magnitude is same. Once again, the process I tell you that you write a vector first and using the same components, but in different order, write the another vector. Here 1, 2 and 3 are the components. In the second vector also 1, 2 and 3 are the components, scalar components, but it is in different order, that's all. Next we shall discuss question number 3. The question is, write two different vectors having same direction. This question will be explained in the next session, because before explaining this question we must discuss about direction ratios and direction cosines. That is the next session topic, so we will do it this question next during the next session. Next question, question number 4, find the values of x and y so that the vectors 2i plus 3j and xi plus yj are equal. Here two vectors are equal. Here given to you 2i plus 3j is equal to xi plus yj. These two vectors are equal. Two vectors are equal if and only if their corresponding components are equal. Means here scalar components, if you check 2, here x is there. So x must be equal to 2. And here instead 3 is there in place of 3, here y is there. So y is equal to 3. So x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3 are the answer. Move on to question number 5. The question is, find the scalar and vector components of the vector with initial point 2, 1 and terminal point minus 5, 7. Here starting point or initial point is given 2, 1 and the ending point or the terminal point is minus 5, 7. Let the points be P, 2, 1 and Q, minus 5, 7. We have already learned a formula, that is if the points are P x1, y1, z1 and Q x2, y2, z2, then vector PQ can be written as x2 minus x1 into I plus y2 minus y1 into j plus z2 minus z1 into k. Here the terminal point is Q and the initial point is P. So PQ can be written as terminal point points first, that is minus 5 minus 2, minus 5 minus 2 into I cap plus 7 minus 1 into j cap. Here z coordinates are not there, so no need to write the third component. That is equal to minus 7 minus 2 is minus 7, minus 7 I cap plus 7 minus 1 is 6 j cap. So here, from here we have to write the scalar and vector components. Here the scalar components are quite clear, minus 7 and 6 are the scalar components. And the vector component sense along with I cap and j cap, that is minus 7i and 6j are the vector components. Once again, here scalar components minus 7 and 6 and the vector components are minus 7i and 6j. Next, question number 6, find the sum of the vectors A. Vector A is equal to I cap minus 2 j cap plus k cap. Vector B is equal to minus 2 I cap plus 4 j cap plus 5 k cap. And C is equal to I cap minus 6 j cap minus 7 k cap. So here we are asked to calculate the sum of the vectors A, B and C. So here A plus B plus C is equal to their scalar components. You have to add first one I cap scalar component is 1. Here it is minus 2, here it is 1. So if you take together 1 minus 2 plus 1 into I cap. Then J components if you take, that is minus 2, here it is plus 4, here it is minus 6. So minus 2 plus 4 minus 6 into J cap plus here 1 K, along with K cap, there is 1 here. Here it is plus 5, here it is minus 7. So 1 plus 5 minus 7 into K cap. Let's go for the calculation. 1 plus 1, 2 minus 2, that is 0 I cap minus here minus 6 minus 2 minus 8 plus 4 is minus 4 j cap. 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 minus 7 is minus 1 k cap. So 0 I cap minus 4 j cap minus 4 k cap. That is equal to minus 4 j cap minus 1 k cap is minus k cap itself. So minus 4 j cap minus k cap is the next. We shall discuss question number 7. Find the unit vector in the direction of the vector A is equal to I cap plus j cap plus 2 k cap. Here we are asked to calculate the unit vector. For calculating the unit vector, first of all we have to calculate the magnitude of the given vector, that is modulus of A is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square is the formula. Here x is 1, y is 1, z is 2. So x square plus y square plus z square, 1 square plus 1 square plus 2 square, that is equal to root of 1 plus 1 plus 2 square is 4, that is root 6. We have got as the magnitude. Then unit vector A we have to calculate. A cap is equal to, we have learned the formula, vector A divided by modulus of vector A. That is equal to vector A is given I plus j plus 2k, that is in the numerator, divided by denominator, the modulus value we have calculated, that is root 6. Now you have to split the denominator, that is here I divided by root 6, means if you split it, 1 divided by root 6 into I, again 1 divided by root 6 into j cap, again 2 divided by root 6 into k cap. That is the way we have to split the denominator, that is 1 by root 6 into I cap plus 1 by root 6 into j cap plus 2 by root 6 into k cap. This is the unit vector in the direction of the given vector. Next we shall discuss question number 8. Find the unit vector in the direction of the vector PQ, where P and Q are points 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6 respectively. Here we are asked to calculate the unit vector in the direction of vector PQ. For calculating vector PQ, we have given the initial and terminal points coordinates 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. If the initial and terminal points are given to you to find out a vector, means we can use the formula x2 minus x1 into I cap plus y2 minus y1 into j cap plus z2 minus z1 into k cap. By using that formula, let's calculate vector PQ. 4 minus 1 into I cap plus 5 minus 2 into j cap plus 6 minus 3 into k cap. Here, terminal point is 4, 5, 6. 4 minus 1 is 3 into I cap plus 5 minus 2 is 3 into j cap plus 6 minus 3, again 3 into k cap. We are asked to calculate the unit vector. So for calculating the unit vector, first of all, we need the magnitude of PQ, or modulus of PQ is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square, that is 3 square plus 3 square plus 3 square. That is root of 9 plus 9 plus 9, that is root 27. Root 27 we can split as 3 root 3. 9 into 3 it will come, then 9 will come out as 3. So 3 root 3 is the modulus value. Then unit vector PQ, that is equal to vector PQ divided by modulus of vector PQ, or magnitude of vector PQ. Vector PQ is, we have got as 3i plus 3j plus 3k divided by the magnitude we have calculated, that is 3 root 3. So when you substitute, 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 3k cap divided by 3 root 3. Just split it, that is 3i cap divided by 3 root 3. So 3, 3 will be cancelled, 1 by root 3 into I cap. Here also 3, 3 will be cancelled, 1 by root 3 into j cap plus, here also 3 and 3 will be cancelled, 1 by root 3 into k cap. So this is the required unit vector. Move on to question number 9. The question is, for given vectors, vector A is equal to 2 I cap minus j cap plus 2 k cap and B is equal to minus I cap plus j cap minus k cap. Find the unit vector in the direction vector A plus B. So here, first of all, we have to find out A plus B, vector A plus vector B. Vector A plus vector B is equal to vector addition in component form. So 2 minus 1 into I cap plus minus 1 plus 1 into j cap plus 2 minus 1 into k cap. When you calculate it is 2 minus 1 is 1i plus minus 1 plus 1 is 0, that is 0 j cap plus 2 minus 1 is 1 k cap. So finally we will get as I cap plus k cap. We have to go for calculating the unit vector in the direction of vector A plus vector B. So vector A plus A vector B we have already calculated. Let's calculate the magnitude. Magnitude of vector A plus vector B is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square. Here x square is 1 square, y square is not there, then z square is 1 square. So root of 1 square plus 1 square, that is equal to root 2. Next, the unit vector is equal to vector A plus vector B divided by modulus of vector A plus vector B. Vector A plus B we have already calculated here, that is I cap plus K cap divided by, its magnitude is root 2. That is equal to 1 by root 2 into I cap plus 1 by root 2 into K cap. So this is the required unit vector. Move on to question number 10. The question is, find a vector in the direction of the vector 5 I cap minus j cap plus 2 k cap, which has a magnitude 8 units. Here, there is a given vector 5 I cap minus j cap plus 2 k cap. We have to find out a vector in the direction of this vector, but the magnitude must be 8 units. So the process is, first of all, you have to find out a unit vector in the direction of the given vector. Then that unit vector, in the sense the magnitude is 1 unit. That unit vector, if you multiply with 8, we will get the required vector. Once again, there is a given vector. First of all, we have to find out the unit vector in the direction of the given vector. Then that unit vector, if you multiply with 8, we will get the required vector, which is in the direction of the given vector and also magnitude 8 units. Let's go for the calculation. The given vector, let's take as vector A is equal to 5i minus j plus 2k. Then let's go for calculating the unit vector. For that, the magnitude we will calculate root of x square plus y square plus z square. That is root of 5 square plus minus 1 the whole square plus 2 square. That is equal to root of 5 square is 25, minus 1 square is plus 1, 2 square is 4. That is equal to root of 30. Then unit vector A we can calculate. Unit vector A, A cap is equal to vector A divided by modulus of vector A, or the magnitude of vector A. Vector A is there, 5y minus j plus 2k, it is given to us, divided by magnitude we have calculated, that is root 30. So a vector parallel to 5y minus j plus 2k with magnitude 8 unit is, here the magnitude is 1. It is a unit vector, that's why the magnitude is 1. So if you multiply this vector with 8, we will get a vector whose magnitude is 8 units. So the required vector is 8 into a cap. You multiplied here 8. 8 into a cap is equal to 8 into 5y minus j cap plus 2k cap divided by root 30. So that is equal to 8 into 5, 40 divided by root 30 into I, again 8 into I cap divided by root 30, again 8 into 2, 16 divided by root 30 into K. So 40 divided by root 30 into I cap minus 8 divided by root 30 into J cap plus 16 divided by root 30 into K cap. My dear students, today we have discussed the basic concepts of vector algebra. Hope it is clear for you all. If you have any doubt, please note it and keep. We will discuss it during the online session. Thank you for watching.